Now that we have Burp Suite installed, in this lecture, I'm going to show you how to use its proxy functionality to intercept requests before they go to the web application. And as a result, we'll be able to see and manipulate inputs that cannot be seen or manipulated using the URL or using normal input boxes that we see on the website. This will obviously allow us to test more features and therefore increases our chances of discovering bugs and vulnerabilities in the target web application. So as you can see here on the top, we have a proxy, and if I click on it, it's already set to on, so the proxy is turned on, and you can click on open browser to open up a normal Chromium browser that this proxy will intercept its requests. Let me show you what I mean. I'm going to click on open browser and let's go to a website. So for example, let's go to zsecurity.org. And as you can see, the website is not loading. It seems like the website is stuck. And the reason why it's stuck, because the request for zsecurity.org got intercepted by our proxy in here. And as you can see in here, we have the full request that is being sent to the website. So you can see the type of request. It's a GET request. It's being sent to /, so it's to the root, to the home directory, because we haven't really specified any files or directories or endpoints after the domain name. You can see the host is zsecurity.org, and you can actually see it in here on the top as well. You could see the cookies that are being sent to the website. These are small files that get exchanged between the website and the target web server. The website uses them to enhance your experience and to set up certain options. And you will see in the future, we can manipulate these cookies to again discover bugs and vulnerabilities. So these cookies are not visible in the URL or in any text boxes, but you'll be able to modify them in here. You can also see the other headers that are being sent to the target web application. But again, you don't really need to worry about them too much right now. We will be talking about them later on. So right now we have options in here. You can either forward this request. So if we click on forward, Burp Proxy is going to let that request go to the target web server. If you click on drop, it's going to drop it. So it's basically going to stop it from reaching its destination. And here, intercept, you can't really see the rest of it. It's basically saying intercept is on, which means that we are actually intercepting all of the requests. So I can simply either forward to forward this request, and I'm going to get the next request. I can forward again, I'll get the next request. So as you can see, sometimes a large number of requests is sent in order to load one single website, or what it seems like one single request in here in your browser. So as soon as you hit enter, you think only one request is being sent to the web application. But in real life, there is much more happening in the background. So you can keep clicking forward until it loads, or you can turn off the interceptor to stop intercepting packets and load the target website. Now, because you're loading our own website, zsecurity.org, we have very strict security settings. That's why you're being stopped by this web page. So even if you solve this captcha, it's not going to let you go through it. So to bypass this, you're going to have to go to the options. We're going to scroll down to the match and replace. And we're going to tick the one that specifies the Mozilla 5 user agent. So we're basically saying we want to replace our user agent with a normal Mozilla user agent, which is used by Firefox. And therefore, this website will hopefully not think that we are using some security tools like Burp Suite. We will talk about the match and replace feature later on in the course. So don't worry about this because we're just using a preset rule in here. So now we can simply just say, I am a human. And it's going to let me through to my target website. Now watch this. We're going to scroll down. And before I click on page 3, I'm going to turn on my interceptor in here. So now any request or anything I click in here will have to pass by Burp Suite. And it'll only go to the target website if I click on forward. And remember, when we clicked on 3 before, all we saw is only one parameter in here that we could manipulate. But watch what happens now if we click on 3. Again, you have the method type. So this time, the method type is post, it's not get. And that's why whatever values that get sent in here are not going to be visible in your URL bar. You can also see the location that this request is being sent to. So previously it was sent to the forward slash to the home, but now it's being sent to wp-admin and admin-ajax.php. Again, you can see the cookies, but the coolest thing and the main thing that is very interesting now is this part right here. So as mentioned earlier, everything we see after an equal sign is a value that is being submitted to the web application. And the web application is going to process this value. And therefore, by modifying this value, we can manipulate the web application and discover vulnerabilities. And as you can see now, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 different values being sent to the web application. This is 8 different inputs that we should test for all of the bugs and vulnerabilities that you will learn later on in the course. So this expands your attack surface by so much, because previously you could have only attacked using only one input, and now you have 8 other inputs that you should test for vulnerabilities. Now you can simply modify any of these values by just putting your cursor in here and changing this to whatever you want to change it to. And again, we will talk about that much more as we go through the course, so you should not worry about this at all. And now we can simply just click on forward to forward that request. And as you can see, page number 3 gets loaded for us because we clicked on forward and that went to the target website. So I'm going to turn off my interceptor and I'm just going to show you one more thing, what we did with the shop. So we're going to go to the shop and we're going to add some products to our cart. And we're going to turn on our interceptor again. And remember last time when we clicked on the X in here, again, all we saw is one parameter to test on the top. Now I'm just going to forward this request that we got in here by something running in the background. And we're going to click on the X to remove this from my cart. And as you can see, right now we have a GET request and we have the endpoint right here. So again, instead of just the parameter that we had last time in the URL, you have 2 more parameters in here. And even though these are GET parameters, so they should be displayed in the URL, you're not seeing them because they're being submitted by JavaScript. So just like the other examples that we talked about, every value you see after an equal sign will be sent to the web application and will be processed by it. And therefore you should manipulate it to discover bugs and vulnerabilities. And similar to what we seen earlier, you can edit this here directly by placing the cursor and typing using your keyboard, or you can click on the inspector in here. This inspector categorizes all of the values that are being sent in here into nice categories. So you can click on the request attributes to see what's being sent in the request. So you can see this request is a GET request to the cart. If you click on the query parameters, you will see the names of the parameters. So remove item and its value, and the WP nouns and its value, and we have them right here. So you can modify them from here by double clicking it and typing whatever you want to type and hit enter, or you could modify it directly in here in plain text. We also have a category here for the body parameters. So this is similar to the values that get sent in here at the bottom, similar to the first example I showed you. You'll be able to see them in here and you'll be able to modify them as well by double clicking them. You can see all of the cookies. So we saw the cookies in here before. You can see them in here also, and you have the cookie name and its value. And again, you can simply modify it by double clicking it and then hitting enter. And finally, we have the request headers. So again, this is pretty much everything that is being sent in here, categorized nicely with the name and the value. Now, we will be using Burp Suite and the proxy in pretty much every single lecture that we're going to do from now onwards. And I'm going to walk you through a lot of its features as I show you and explain to you other bugs and vulnerabilities. So you're going to be learning a number of things in every lecture. So don't worry at all about all of the other tabs and don't get overwhelmed about this application. You're not going to have to figure out anything by yourself. I will walk you through everything step by step. But the main thing that I wanted to show you in this lecture is how to use this program to intercept requests and how useful that is. Because like I said, it's going to radically increase the size of your attack surface, allowing you to test more parameters and therefore increasing your chances of discovering bugs and vulnerabilities in your target.